Hi guys, I wanted to make one more tutorial on this watercolor effects. This time I'm going to work with this image. I have no idea how to pronounce the name. I guess it's Shai, her daughters and her grandson. So this is going to be the end result and I'm going to start from here. First of all, I'm showing that because I have small faces and the action will act differently in small faces. Like if you have a few people in a group, you have to go to your image first, image size, and make sure when you have large groups, not close-up photo, your resolution is 300. So you have to have 300 pixel per inch. And for the purpose of the tutorial, I'm going to reduce the size of this image. And when you reduce the size, make sure you have the settings just like mine. And when I reduce the size, it has to be linked, otherwise it's going to be distorted. So I'm going to reduce the size, let's say 20. But make sure you have, you do not reduce the size of this, the image. I am reducing it because of the tutorial, because it's going to take way too long to work on this. Make sure you're 300 when you have small faces. Okay, I'm going to click here and it's going to become bigger actually instead of smaller. This action is going to actually simplify the things, and when you have such small detail like eyes, it's going to smudge them and make them even simpler than this. And the baby is going to be completely distorted because it's so small. But I'm going to show you how to deal with the problem. So let's go to watercolor effect. And it's still a big image and it's going to take a little time to process. But I just wanted to tell you that it works the best on closer faces because it's not going to oversimplify it. Look at her shadows around her eyes. They are going to become even more pronounced. The action is going to make the darker stuff darker and the lighter stuff lighter, and the lines are going to be simplified like a watercolor painting would be. And I'm going to show you how you can deal with this problem. So if something like this happened, you have to turn the filters one by one to see where the problem is. Or most likely it's going to be into dry brush or cut out. And here it is. It's not that bad. And this is how a water painting would look like for real. So you can, I know this problem is here with dry brush. You can click off that. It's going to take time to process, but you're going to see that it's this problem here is in the dry brush. And you can actually switch off completely if you like it, but I like here how it is now. But I do like the effect, so I'm going to turn it on and I'm going to just remove it from the eyes. Just a little bit, not 100%, because I still like the look of the watercolor. And it's a big image still, takes time. So I'm going to click on the layer mask here. And I'm going to grab my brush. It has to be black, B for my brush. Grab your brush, black, but I'm going to put a normal brush because apparently I have one of my watercolor brushes. Making sure I have my layer mask active. It has to be active like you see it with these lines around. If you're on the layer smart object, it's not going to work. So make sure you have the layer mask active. And I'm going to be, actually I suggest you to do this on the very end. Okay? So you don't make some mistakes, but I'm going to make it now. So let's go with 100% opacity to show you. You can completely remove everything. and it comes back to normal. But I don't like that, so I'm going to go double back. I'm going to put my brush in 10% opacity or so and remove some of it, and I will leave some of it. On the very end, you can Photoshop it if you don't like it. She does have some shadows around her eyes. Naturally, it may be the makeup or maybe how she is. Sometimes I will remove everything, all the effects from the very middle, so I can have catch lights and stuff. And let's do it on her too. And you're going to see baby face is kind of missing. So I'm going to make my brush bigger, and I'm going to remove the effect of baby, so we can see the baby more. Baby is really, really small, and the effect is, I don't want him 100% natural, not like painting, but I still want to see eyes, mouth. So I'm painting off in 10% opacity, so I can do it gradually, and that looks good to me. Now I can, everything else looks like painting. Look at the dress, the hair. Okay, so I have to crop now as my action set. C for my crop tool. And I'm going to add some canvas on the sides. And I'll go OK. Again, it's going to take a little time to render all of the filters. It's not going to give me preview how it is for real when the filters are done. It's a little time. Sorry about that. It's not more than a minute. It just looks a little bit too much when you do a tutorial. Here we go. Now I'm going to go and import paper. And my paper is located here, and I'm going to use this one. That's my favorite. And I will make sure, as my stop says, the paper to go all the way up. I'm holding my shift to distort it because I'm with 2019. If you're with the older, you should not hold your shift. And now I'm going to grab one of my brushes. B for my brush. I'm going to grab one of my brushes which come with the action. And I don't know which one. Let's go with this one. Okay. Making sure I am in white, X to switch my color, so click here, and this is how the brush is set, and I'm going to start revealing them. So what I want here is, I want the faces to be revealed 100% and the rest not to be revealed 100%. So I'm going to grab, bring it close, and I'm going to paint here. Let me make it smaller. Trying to do it as fast as I can. I want as little as I can from the dark, because usually watercolor painting is transparent media, and it's never going to be really dark unless it is gouache, not the transparent watercolor. So I'm making sure to see the faces. As soon as I see the faces, especially the eyes, the other stuff I can leave transparent, so it looks more like water painting. I personally like this one a little bit more water paint. I like it light. B for my brush, making it bigger, and I can be sloppy here now, bringing the picture back. Okay, I want as little as I can from the gray, so it looks more like watercolor. The best thing about this is it's a matter of choice. Whatever you like looks the best. Okay, let me come here, make it smaller, make sure I have the shape of her hair, the basic shape, making sure I have that baby, her arm, and I like the transparency. Let me show some arms here, and tapping here and there, I'm not actually painting. And I went out of the border here, so I'm going to X to switch the colors, and I'm going to remove this. I'm painting this time, I'm not just tapping. I'm going to remove that. Then I'm going to switch my brush to something else, so I don't have a pattern of repeat on the sides. I have no idea which one. Let's go with this one. X to switch the color. I don't like this one. About that. I like this one, but I just don't like it from this picture. So I'm going to grab one of these real watercolor. Let me make it smaller. X to switch the color. I want to remove this spot here. And again, X to switch the color, and I'm going to add to her arm here. So I'm not going to go back and forward. Let's add the dresses a little bit. Baby is inside, making the brush smaller, and I'm going to switch the color, and I'm going to go to her as close as I can and remove the gray, the dark gray. And again, this is a matter of choice. Like it, leave it there. You can actually okay, let's say it looks good. You can actually just add an empty layer. That same brush or some other brush, you can sample from the dress, let's say here, something like, let's say here. I'm going to reduce the opacity of that brush and do a few strokes here to give it some color. My brush is really low opacity, and I'm kind of painting around. You can actually paint the border if you want to with this color. I'm doing it really sloppy, but this is art. It is whatever you like. It's good. So there are no rules. So let me go back really close. I like the empty spaces, I really do. And if you don't like it, of course, fill it up before my brush. Make it 100% opacity. Here it's a little bit too empty, so I'm going to make it smaller. And I'm going to make sure I'm in white color. X to switch the color, and I'm going to bring her hair. It's a little too transparent. I don't want to bring more of that side, making sure baby's into the picture. It's very important. And I like that transparency here. So I let it stay like this, and I'm going to go and show you how I would finish it. Let me just put this part, making sure eyes are inside. I'm going to show you how I will finish this image. I'm going to click on the very bottom, on the very top active layer, and I'm going to make stamp visible layer. Command Option Shift E for Mac, Control Alt Shift E for PC. Now I have a solid layer. I'm going to right click, and I'm going to turn it into a smart object. Then I'm going to go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. Now here in Camera Raw Filter, I want to add some contrast and some texture. Here is the texture. I'm going to add some texture, and adding the texture immediately makes it more colorful. So let me just reduce it. I'm adding a little bit of texture, and I'm going to bring the detail into the shadows. So it looks like really like painting now, and I still want blacks, so I'm going to bring blacks, and I think it looks good so far. So far, so good. And I'm going to go okay. I like it as is. Perfect. And here what I did in the camera raw filter. And if there is something you don't like, you can always double click camera. It's going to go back. Let's say you did it a little bit too black, too bright, too something. You can adjust it from here. I personally like it. Okay. And that's pretty much all that editing. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.